Good evening. It's now 6 o'clock, so we will begin this meeting, the first council meeting of February. Thank you everyone for coming. This meeting is now called to order. We will stand for the invocation by Pastor Poyntville.
Chair will pray. Dear Father, we're thankful for this time that we can come together and to meet as community members to think about the interest of this community. We're thankful for those that are willing to serve. We know it's a sacrifice on their part, and we appreciate that. We're thankful for all those who help make this city to work, especially in the type of weather that we've been having of late. We're thankful for those that have cleared the roads for us, and we ask for their continued safety. We ask that you would be with our council members as well as they think about their running again for office, and we ask that their campaigns to be done so in an ethical way. Help us each to reason with one another and to be considerate of one another even when we disagree. Be with their deliberations tonight to help them do what's best for the city. We're thankful again for all those who are able to be here this evening. In the name of our Redeemer we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor. Do we have any Boy Scouts waiting in the wings? Girl Scouts? All right, well, let's all join together then with the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. The minutes of the last regular session of council have been distributed from a month ago, January 5th. I need a motion and a second to approve those minutes as distributed.
So moved.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you. All those in favor signify with your right hand. Thank you. And now the order of the agenda, are there any changes or additions?
Mayor and council, there appear to be some questions about item number 8. I'd like to pull that from the agenda.
Okay, we will delete that then. And that's the extent. I need a motion and a second to approve the order of agenda as now changed. Thank you.
Section.
Thank you. All those in favor, signify with your right hand. None opposed. We'll come to the information presentation and public hearing portion of the meeting. And we have the opportunity to have the annual tourism report given by Ms. Debbie Fountain, Tourism Director.
Good evening. I'm happy to be here. I always like to start this by saying thank you. Thank you to the city and thank you to the City Council. You know, we could not put on all these events and festivals if it weren't for the cooperation of the city, because it involves the Parks and Rec Department often, the Fire Department, the Police Department, law enforcement, just blocking off for the parades and things like that. We all appreciate all that extra staff time it takes. I'm always calling up asking the city to put up some more trash cans for events, and they're always very cooperative, all the people that work for you, and so I just wanted to say thank you to the City Council for that. This has been a great year. 2014 has been a great year, and we've added some new items in town, new events. And so one of the first things that happened was early in the year, we redid the Visit Kirksville website. And I think when I was here with an economic update in July, I sort of told you about that, but I wanted to tell you that it's been great. It's very clean looking, very pretty website. It's very clear on all the mobile devices, and almost everyone plans their trips, their visits, their vacations on the website now. So we have had 26,000 visits to our new website, and that's a 20% increase over last year. We've been very pleased, and I want to remind you again that we were able to use a local company to do that, Love Built Inc., and so we were very happy that some of that lodging tax money that came in came to you and then to the tourism office, and we actually put it back out into the community because we spent quite a bit of money on the new website. So we were very happy that we had a local vendor for that. We have a new welcome sign on North 63 that was put up, I think, last May or June. We placed one at the corner of Illinois and 63 in the fall of 2013, and then about June of 2015, we placed the other Welcome to Kirksville sign up north. Those two signs are part of the new entrance to Kirksville now that there's the new Highway 63, and so we also were able to use a local sign company to build those signs, and we were happy to use that money and keep that money here in town. We have had a lot of new events. My goal every year is to have all the events we had the previous year and then add some new events. So I think in 2014, we have a new Kirksville Brewers Guild, and they had a couple brewers competitions, and that is a group of great enthusiastic young people that I think will continue to have an annual event. We had a barbecue contest, the North Star Rotary Barbecue Contest. This was great. It was a sanctioned event, and that brings a lot of barbecue aficionados from other places. So they come into town and stay overnight and enter the barbecue contest. Since this was with North Star Rotary, I'm encouraging them to have that be their annual fundraiser, because I would love it if we had a barbecue contest every year. The Conservation Department did something new. They had a hunting and fishing day for kids, and they had that out at the fairgrounds, and it was a great event. It was in the summer. And so I really appreciate all those volunteer groups to, you know, that takes a lot of effort. We have a lot of volunteers that make these visit events happen. We had a lot of new groups that held conferences in Kirksville. The Missouri Medical College Association was here in 2014. The Palm Shadows Reunion. This was one of my favorites, and I'll just stop and tell you, there were a group of people that go down to South Texas to winter every year, and they're from Iowa and Missouri, and one couple is from Kirksville, Beverly and Earl Powell. And so this group that winters in Texas has a summer reunion, and every year it had been in Iowa. And finally Beverly Powell said to her friends, let's go to Kirksville one year. So all these people, and even though they live in trailers all winter in Texas, they stayed in the hotels for their reunion. I thought that was great. So instead of bringing their campers, they stayed in our hotels, and they had a wonderful time. We also hosted the National Association of Music Teachers competition. We had a Missouri Humanities Council workshop. We had a Speak Association reunion. And we had the Freshman Legislative Tour, which I put in the category of new events because the new legislators had not come to Kirksville since 2004, so to me that was a new event because we haven't had them since we've had the tourism office. We had dozens of events that we have every year, and we just like to try to make them better, make them longer. The lodging tax for 2014 was $154,998.32. That was a very good year. That's right about the average. We hosted two hotel employee orientations. This is for the desk clerks and anybody that the hotel manager wants, including the cleaning staff, because those are usually sometimes the first people that a guest meets when they come to town, is the person behind the hotel desk, and we want them to be good tourism ambassadors. So the tourism office takes the time to let those desk clerks and housekeeping staff be tourists in their own town for a day. So they come to our office, we take them on tours, we take them to museums, we take them to parks, they have speakers, they have lunch. And I think though that's good because those are usually entry-level positions, and a lot of the people have not participated or visited a museum or been a tourist in their own town, and so they can talk about good places to eat or good things to do when they're here. So that's been great. We try to do that every year. And this is, I think 2014 was the first year that we actually had two different times that we did employee orientations. We have a tourism partnership budget. That's, our tourism board has given some money in a special budget that we partner with other groups that are putting on events so that they can spend the money to advertise and bring more participants from further away. We use $18,850 this year to promote 12 events, including the Young Farmers Truck and Tractor Pull. And I picked that one out of the hat because that started just 4 years ago, and it has grown so fast that they had 200 spectators the first year, and just this summer, this fall, they had almost 2,000 spectators, and it is now a nationally sanctioned truck and tractor pull. In fact, the Young Farmers Association were given the 2014 Tourism Event of the Year Award at the Chamber Banquet in January. We like to encourage them to keep growing. One of the goals for 2015 is to have our tourism office add to the events that are already here. For example, I hope to work with the Livestock Symposium. That's a great event that's every year. I like it to be one day longer so that the guests stay in town one more day, stay in the hotels one more night, spend more money while they're here. We hope to have add-on tours, add-on days, so when we have a lot of things on the calendar for 2015. But for example, there will be a Rotary District Conference in October of 2015. I want to have a day trip add-on so people can come early and go on tours of the community, or they can stay an extra day at the end so that we keep them here while they're already here for an event. We work really closely with lots of people in the city. One of my jobs is to help promote the airport and Cape Air. We continue to do that all the time. We have the tourism office keeps brochures and maps. You know, we have a big sign that lists the taxi services and our shuttle service out right at the airport. We do the same thing at the train station. We help, we partner with Cape Air. We had a billboard again this year where we paid half of it and Cape Air paid half of it to promote people to use the airline and visit Kirksville. It's been great that the city has added new things. I loved it when I just have had the new visitor's guide reprinted. And by the way, we always use local printers for that. And we vary our printing things to the different printers in town. But and I was very happy to add McKinney Dog Park to one of the most interesting things that we have in town. That's been on our Visit Kirksville website since it opened, but now it's in our visitor's guide also. And just that alone will bring people to town because they'll get off the highway and they'll come enjoy that park. And so I thank the city council and all the volunteers that helped make that happen. We were happy to add the welcome sign this year, and I'm also on the Flats Committee. That's Forest Lake Area Trail Systems. It's very exciting that in December they completed phase one of that, and I'm really encouraging the committee to do the second part where we start in town and head out. So pretty soon we'll be like the Intercontinental Railroad and we'll meet in the middle in a few years and have that whole trail done. But it takes a step at a time, and as I do this annual report every year, I like to see what we have added in the way of attractions into the town, because that's great. We had one new hunting lodge opened, the Pure Air Cabin, the Bin, just outside of town, and it's always nice to have one more lodging facility. I'm always working at trying to talk someone into opening a new bed and breakfast. You know, we lost a bed and breakfast a couple years ago when Mac and Joe McCord retired, and I'm still encouraging, including all of you, if you'd like to open a bed and breakfast in your home, I'll be happy to help you market it. That's just one more interesting thing for our visitors to do. You received in your written packet a whole report that's required by our contract between the Chamber and the city of all the details. I don't want to take up any more time here, but I'm always happy to answer your questions. So if you have any now, or you're welcome to contact me later.
Here we are having some new signage coming via the airport. How's that coming along?
Yes, that's very exciting. Glenn Ballou, the airport director, is getting a new sign out there, and then the tourism office is going to kind of inherit the old sign, and it will go at the corner of Jefferson and Franklin in front of the Chamber and Tourism office, and we will be delighted to have that LED sign where we can have one more way to do public relations for our festivals and things like that. So part of our tourism budget is going to be spent this year to move that sign and pay for the new pole to have it right there. So that's a great partnership with the city.
A very, very thorough report. I know my partner and myself certainly enjoyed the art walk this past year.
Yes, that was a great, I love the art walk because that was a partnership with the KDIC, the Chamber, the Tourism Office, the city helped with it. And I think that's the way we get things done up here in North Missouri, is we partner together and do a good job working together to make things happen. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Lastly, Debbie and I were in the same high school class, and I realize she looks a lot younger than I do, but
yeah.
Same high school class.
Okay, that's a rumor.
Thank you so much. All right. Good job. This is a chance for any citizens to participate in the, to share their opinions or comments or questions. You have a 5-minute window of time, and when you do come to the podium, as you're more than welcome to now, sir, please state your name and you may write your address.
Yeah, my name is Roland Wilhite. I was up here January the 5th, I think, for another council meeting.
Correct.
And I asked about my camper, which has, I've got 2 letters on it, that it cannot be parked where it's been for, since we moved out there in 19, we've been out there about 26 years altogether. And when we moved out there, there was no sewer, no water out there, on rural water. And nothing was ever said about it until here just November, and Brad come out and said I had to move it. And it's not bothering any of the neighbors. In fact, I had a neighbor across the street said, I'll come up here tonight with you if you want me to come. And I said, well, there's no reason to, because actually I've got 2 acres out there and I've got plenty of places to park it, but that ground out there is so soft I can't move it in the back of the property because I don't have no driveway, and I'll tear up the yard getting it back there. And where it's parked at, it's on the other side of the driveway in front of the garage with the shrubs around it, and I don't see any reason why I should move it. I have moved it temporarily, but as soon as the snow goes off, I'm going to have to move it back over there. And
Mr. Wilhite, the council was going to talk about it at their next study session. The one they had this evening was for the state of the city, and it didn't give them time to talk about it.
Okay.
Brad was informed not to do anything further till the council made a decision. Well, so
my neighbors also need to come up here with me, if, because it's, no, I've got, like I said, it's corn fields out there, there's around it and everything. It's a rural area, really, in the city limits. And that's why we bought out there, because of the fact we didn't have all these zoning laws out there, so we didn't figure a junkyard would be around it. And I try to keep the yard up, and I can see a bit of difference between my motorhome sitting there and my pickup sitting there.
The next time the council will be meeting is March 2nd.
Okay.
Okay?
All right.
So I can let you know what they discuss after that.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, Merlin, thank you.
Thank you for coming. Sometimes we have a tough problem with enforcing ordinances. Is there anyone else that would like to speak their piece? Okay, so that portion is closed, and we'll move on to the action presentations. I need a motion and a second to approve a resolution expressing appreciation to Clayton Delabue for his service on the Watershed Management Commission.
So moved.
Thank you, thank you. Alan, would you be so kind to bring a report on these kind of accomplishments?
Good evening, Council. Clayton is the best chairman of the Watershed Management Commission I have had the pleasure to serve under. Of course, sorry, Clayton, but so far you're the only one.
The only one.
But in my short time, I have found that he's very dedicated and very knowledgeable in this area, and very concerned to be sure that Kirksville maintains the watershed for the best possible water quality. And I hate to see him leave, but life moves on. So personally, I just want to wish Clayton very well in the future.
And for the city council, because none of you were on the council at the time, but when the city council chose to sell land around Hazel Creek, the community, not only residents in the city, but you know, residents around the county were concerned about the water quality, and the council set up a watershed commission. Clayton stepped up to participate in that. He brings a lot of knowledge. He's brought a lot of knowledge. But the other thing that he's done is he's brought some common sense approach. It's very easy to take the numbers, the science, and try to make it say some things. But he's taken an open-eyed approach and, you know, helped a number of people to understand what is really going on out there. And I think that has been a credit to his leadership, and also it's helped us quite a bit because it took a very volatile situation and diffused it to the point where it's a good thing. And so I think, Clayton, you should be commended for that.
I want to show the highest respect possible to this resolution. I have a variety of emotions in presenting this resolution. When I first came back to Kirksville 3 years ago, Clayton and Janet were one of the couples that welcomed me back to the city, and they showed kindnesses to me when I was going through my travails, and you know, even asked me to work with them on refinishing some of their decks. So I'll go ahead and read this. Please come forward, you and your lovely spouse. A resolution of appreciation to Clayton Delavue for service on the Watershed Management Commission. Whereas Clayton Delavue has served the city of Kirksville with dedication and distinction as a member and chairman on the Watershed Management Commission since the commission members were first appointed in September 2005. And whereas Clayton's years of service have been marked by exemplary and energetic leadership and the vital accomplishments of this commission. And whereas Clayton has announced his resignation as a member of this commission, now therefore be it resolved that the Watershed Commission members, the City Council, and the citizens of Kirksville commend Clayton Delavue for his outstanding efforts and express our appreciation for his leadership in all areas of community interest and improvement. Passed by the City Council and signed by the Mayor the second day of February 2015. Thank you so very, very much.
Members of the commission that are here, if we can get a picture with three of you and then maybe have them come up.
Okay, thank you. Okay. So maybe even Janet.
No, well, I'm not on the commission.
Well, the three of us. Why don't we back up just a touch? I don't know about how all these cameras work.
You want to turn around so we can see the resolution.
There we go. Please hang on, you two. The other commission members of the Watershed Commission.
Would you like to be in a picture? Would you like Jim, Cindy?
You?
Alan, you might as well.
You're a former member.
Mark, you were a long time on the commission for a while.
I was. Right. Yeah.
You got a lot.
I was too, Mark.
Can I sing? Yeah. You can stand in front.
I don't know. Here we get everybody here.
And it's a Glenn.
Okay, one, two, three, smile. Quit laughing, Glenn. Okay, one, two, three, smile.
Well, the good news is, this is the only City Council meeting this month. We'll give folks a chance to...
Vicki, I know it's anonymous.
Oh, thank
not
you.
Not anonymous, but
I was thinking we would have to vote.
You want to vote?
Well, shall we all vote for the approval of that resolution with your right hand? Okay. Vicki, would you be so kind to read bill number 05?
A resolution of the City of Kirksville, Missouri to amend a funding agreement with the Northeast Missouri Solid Waste Management District, Region C, for the Kirksville Glass Recycling Program and establishing the mayor and city manager as authorized representatives for the city of Kirksville.
Okay, thank you. I need a motion and a second for that. Thank you. Thank you, gents. Sarah, this is great.
This is the grant that we applied for in 2014. We applied and then they had us reapply in August. And we were notified on December 31st that our grant was approved. It's a grant for $35,000. We're coming today to ask to amend the agreement because we found that the bunker we had designed was too large for the amount of glass that we believe we'll be collecting. We do estimate that we'll collect approximately 200 tons per year. And every 24 tons that we collect, they will haul it off for us. The funds we use to purchase and build a bunker for the glass collection and drop-off site, Public Works Complex. The drop-off service will be free to Kirksville and Adair County residents, and we plan to coordinate that with our household hazardous waste drop-offs. Advanced Disposal will provide a free curbside pickup to anyone within the city of Kirksville who is interested. And it'll be, I believe, the same once a month collection. So we're requesting an amendment to actually benefit us, where it will actually cost us less to build the bunker. There's $35,000 in grant funds. It is a 75-25 match, and we are requesting an amendment that will total, with local match of cash and in kind, of $11,666.66. There is $11,599 in city funds budget for this project right now, and we'll increase it, the grant amount, from $26,633 to $35,000 as well.
Very, very, very important project for the care of our environment. Is there any other council discussion?
Is the bunker going to be built at Public Works?
It will be built at Public Works.
Thank you.
And we'll have drop-off sites also at the community opportunities, and then Truman will collect on campus as well. Advanced Disposal will actually haul it from those locations to the Public Works Complex for us as well.
The community, the opportunity works, that is mm-hmm. going to be for public drop-off. Mm-hmm. The Truman, as Sarah said, I just want to emphasize, that is for recycled for glass generated on Truman's campus, mm-hmm. not a drop-off
Correct.
For everyone
Correct.
Else.
Yeah.
I'm sure there'll be a lot of glass there.
And we'll coordinate with people as they come in because we want to make sure that nothing's being put in there that isn't acceptable.
Exactly.
And then they're also looking to try and help the downtown merchants as well with their glass collection. And we'll discuss that with them and come up with a solution for them.
Did you say, or will you say, when is the projected date of the actual implementation?
We will hopefully have that done before the end of the year is our goal.
Definitely, of course, considered as part of our contract with the Mass Disposal.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Any other citizen questions or input? All those in favor of this, seem to have your right hand. Thank you, Sarah. Vicki, would you be so kind to read bill number 06?
A resolution of the City Council of Kirksville, Missouri, authorizing the mayor to execute a second amendment the lease agreement with Syndeo Corporation for city property located at 3010 Industrial Road.
Thank you very much. I need a motion and a second. Thank you.
Mayor and Council, we have an opportunity to work with Syndeo and in the same respect enhance our building, the 3010 Industrial Building that we own. Syndeo would like to improve the lighting that they have with energy efficient lighting. The program that they're looking at, there's a rebate that is provided. There's a dollar amount rebate depending upon the amount of work that is done that is provided, and then that offsets part of the cost. And then with the monthly bills, those will be reduced as well due to the improved lighting. What the agreement basically says is that over the course of 12 months, Syndeo will reimburse the city in 12 equal payments. Will upfront the cost, and there's a contractor that they've already worked with other facilities that they have, and you know, I think it's a win-win all the way around for the city. It's our building, but we're going to get $65,000 worth of new lighting in the facility.
Wow, great. Any council discussion on that? Citizen question or input? All those in favor, signify with your right hand. Thank you. Vicki Beeser, County Bill Number 07.
An ordinance determining capture of economic activity taxes of Melody School of Dance and Tumbling of Kirksville that relocated to the downtown tax increment financing redevelopment area after December 27, 1999.
Thank you. Motion and a second for that bill, please.
So moved.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, Sarah,
again. And back. In 99, the city approved the formation of the Downtown Tax Increment Financing District, and the TIF district generates revenues through capture of sales tax and property taxes. We were given advice by our bond council to contact the businesses that relocate from within the city and ask them their reasons for moving into the TIF, and based on that, the council is to decide for those that relocate. Any new business that comes in is automatically added. But if they relocate, so if they were in existence before, we have to make that decision. When we contacted Melody's, she said that they had lost their location that they were currently at, and they liked the central location. They liked that people could visit the other establishments downtown and grab a bite to eat perhaps in between. And so we felt they wanted to contribute to the TIF. So our recommendation is that we do add them to it. Being a dance studio, they don't have, it's a lot of a service, so it won't be a large increase. I believe for the past year, it was not a small amount, but it does add to the TIF. So at this point, we would recommend that we include them.
Okay, thanks. Any other council discussion? Questions? Citizen question input? All those in favor, signify with your right hand. Thank you. Thank you, Sarah. Vicki, number 08, please.
An ordinance determining capture of economic activity taxes of Security Finance of Missouri, LLC of Kirksville that relocated to the South 63 Corridor Tax Increment Financing Redevelopment Area after July 20th, 2009.
Wow, and Ben O'Mac again. Let's see. Did we get a motion a second? No, I need a motion a second on that. Okay, now.
This is very similar to the one that we just did, other than it's in the South 63 Corridor Tax Increment Financing District. This business actually currently does not collect any sales tax. However, we felt that since they could change the scope of their business in the future, it would be a good idea to determine whether or not to include them at this time rather than, you know, trying to decide later or, and then have to backtrack. They said that their main reason was they liked the location there as well. So we did decide to go along with it. They liked the parking was better there, easier access than where they were previously located. So at this time, we would recommend that we also include them in the capture of the TIF.
Okay, thank you, Sarah. Any council discussion or citizen question? All those in favor, signify with your right hand, please. Thank you. Wow. Sarah's going to appear again here. Vicki, please read bill number 09.
An ordinance of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, authorizing the execution of a contract between the City of Kirksville and the Missouri Highways and Transportation Commission for Transportation Alternatives Program funds and establishing the mayor and city manager as authorized representatives for the City of Kirksville.
Thank you, Vicki. Motion and a second for that bill, please.
So moved.
Thank you. Thank you. Sarah.
This is my final item for tonight, I promise.
Okay.
We are asking for the approval of a grant that we applied for in November of 2014. It's the Transportation Alternative Program, or the TAP grant, as we call it. What we're hoping to do with that is to build sidewalks along Halliburton Street between La Harpe Street and Franklin, and then also along Florence from La Harpe up to the north end of the Truman State University parking lot by the tennis courts. The grant notification came on December 29th, and we were awarded $190,800. The total project is estimated at $238,500. The city will provide $47,700 in matching funds and in-kind labor. The in-kind makes up about 15.7 of that. We already had $400 budgeted for improvements to Halliburton Street, so we'll take $32,000 out of the asphalt line and move it to the concrete line within the transportation sales tax to fund the remainder of that. And so we're asking for approval for that grant and for the mayor and city manager to be authorized to sign future documents.
Sounds like a pretty good deal. The high percentage of the amount there is mm-hmm. a grant.
Mm-hmm. And it will increase connectivity, especially for, it'll connect to the Safe Routes to School sidewalks that we're building right now along the HARP. So it really does connect the pieces, also makes for safer access. One of the things that we had put in the grant was it provides safer access with a dog to the dog park. Rather than walking along Franklin, where there's cars right by you, if you walk this, then you're in a separate sidewalk, so there's a curb at least.
Yeah, very good. Okay, any other council discussions? Citizen question and answer? All those in favor, signify with your right hand, please. If you'd be so kind to read bill number 10.
An ordinance of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, granting a special use permit for the construction of a radio tower antenna on Kirksville R3 property at 1901 East Hamilton Street.
Thank you. Need a motion and a second for that bill?
So moved.
Thank you, gentlemen. Sure. Okay, Brad, please.
This special use permit had been requested by the Kirksville R3 School District. Dr. Kazire is here tonight. We've been working on this project. The school district has been working on finding a way to improve radio communications with their school buses and with their school contractor. They've considered mounting antennas on our water tower, which would be something they could wire together. They discarded that idea after some consultations with companies. That wasn't going to work. They believe that a lattice type tower, which is similar to us, basically similar to what our old cell tower looked like here behind the building, would be the best way to get that to be constructed on city property. They believe that it would be no taller, the antenna and the tower together, would be no taller than 100 feet. The reason they're doing this is because current ordinances, the school district's in an R1 zoning district, said no buildings higher than 35 feet, so we felt this was the best way to address this need for improved communications. We believe, and they believe, that that'll give them very good 100% coverage for radio anywhere in their district. This day and age, I think we can all understand the importance of good communication for radios in case of emergencies, things that happen. We did have a public hearing on this before the Planning and Zoning Commission a few weeks ago. No one spoke in opposition to this. The Planning and Zoning Commission did vote unanimously to support this special use permit. We did have certified letters sent out to all property owners. We did not receive any written communication opposing or no verbal communication either. So if you have any questions, or Mr. Kazire would be willing to answer questions too, I believe, but pretty straightforward. I think this would help them with their communication problem.
Just a clarification, it's on the school district's property.
Yes.
You had stated city property.
Oh, did I? Okay.
Yeah, it's on the school district's property.
It is on school district property only. It could be by either one of two buildings. They have not yet decided which would be the best. Fall zone for the tower would not impact any residential property. It would all be on school property somewhere. It's pretty open in the areas that they're looking at.
I would like to make a comment. I think this is really a great thing because of the world situation we're in today with emergency situations. This gives them the opportunity, if they have a lockdown, to call those buses off from coming into the school if they're transporting the right. school at that time. So, an emergency, it affects other things. The storms, if a bus breaks down and there's an emergency as far as an accident. These are great things to have, and this is just upgrading another part of the school system.
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Okay, any other council or citizen question or input? I thank you for coming to tonight's meeting. You represent the school district. All those in favor of this bill, so sing that with your right hand. Okay, thank you. As we approved earlier, we will be tabling item number 8 for later.
Not tabling, it's just not on your agenda this evening.
Oh, okay. Appreciate that. Correct. We're here. Thank you. So Need a motion and a second to approve an agreement with the Kirksville Regional Economic Development Incorporated, doing business as K-Ready for Economic Development Services. Thank you. Thank you. Staff report, please.
Mayor and Council, you were sent the agreement via a different, separate email from when the agenda went out. Basically, the agreement was what would, had been provided previously to the council. Just want to go over a couple of things. In a prior meeting, the council did approve funding for 3 years. This agreement does include that. It also makes a change as to who will be on. Be the city appointees for the chamber board, or excuse me, K-Ready board, which will be the mayor, mayor pro tem, city manager, and assistant city manager. The agreement, and then a fifth person, which will be a community representative, and there's an action item for you to consider appointing Annette Sweet, who's been serving for this, on behalf of the city for a couple of years. Other things, you know, we wanted them to look at their bylaws. We wanted their assistance in helping us secure the half-cent economic development sales tax in the near future. And we also wanted basically more responsibility for the day-to-day operations under the executive director as opposed to the board. So K-Ready had reviewed and approved the agreement last Thursday, I believe, and it's being presented to the City Council for consideration this evening. I will say, you know, a lot of discussion about the appointees for the city, and at the end of the day, what at least the consensus was from the council is that you would establish your own economic development committee, and the number of people, you all have to discuss that, you know, but we'll be bringing that back to you so you can look at what's their purpose and, you know, move forward from there.
We've had a number of discussions about this recently, you know, really most all of which have been positive. In a recent meeting with the city manager, you know, she and I both agreed that, you know, all this hard work, you know, will culminate in very, very positive agreement with K-Ready. Any other council discussion or citizen question or input? Okay, all those in favor of this agreement, so signify with your right hand. All those opposed? And there are none abstaining. That vote is clear. Okay. I need a motion and a second to authorize the mayor to execute an agreement with Judge B.B. Powell Sutton from Municipal Judge Services.
So moved.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you. Mary, please.
Mayor and Council, Judge Sutton, I'm sorry, it's a new name. She's Phoebe Powell for many years. But Judge Sutton has been our municipal judge for about 16 years. And she has served us faithfully, is here to court on a regular basis. Courts usually, we usually have court every Thursday, you know, with a few off weeks. But anyway, Phoebe has done a good job for us. We have presented the agreement to her, which she has approved, and recommend that the City Council approve it as well. The agreement is for, it's a multi-year agreement. And I'm sorry, it's for 3 years. Just wanted to make sure I had that right.
Thank you, Mary. Any council discussion? Citizen question, please. All those in favor, so see you guys right here. Anyone? I need a motion and a second to approve the purchase of the 80 by 80 aircraft hangar at the Kirksville Regional Airport.
So moved.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you. All right. Glenn, you've been speaking a lot tonight.
Oh, I just got started, Mr. Mayor. Keep going.
Okay.
Mr. Mayor, Council, you know, this has been in the works for a while now. It was on, it was off, it was on, it was off. I went a couple of weeks ago and briefed the K-Ready board on what the airport's plans were for the 80 by 80 hangar and why we offered them what we offered them, and they made a vote and agreed to sell it. We're giving $40,000 for the hangar, and based on the real estate at the airport and what other hangars have sold for, I think that's a fair deal on the hangar.
We have averaged a little over $600 a month rent on it since I've been there. So based on that, $40,000 will take about 5.5 years to pay it off. We're going to look at insulating and heating it. We can make more money out that way. It also gives us the opportunity to have that service to provide our transient airplanes. The bigger guys who just stop in can't fit in a T-hanger. So again, we'll rent the hangar, but we will also make other funds on selling the fuel to the guys because they stop here because we have the hangar. So there's other ways we'll generate revenue off of that, but we have actually put an 80 by 80 hangar revenue line into our budget so we can track what we're making on that and see how long it takes it to pay it off. Again, I think 5 to 6 years is an easy, I think, very realistic time frame to pay that hangar off and be clear with it, just on the revenues that we're going to bring in from it. So right. Based on your questions.
This will bring all of the buildings on the airport property under the control of the city.
No, Mr. Mayor. We have there's a couple hangars there that are privately owned, but we own the ground that they sit on. We lease the ground to them.
Okay.
All the leases say that hey, once if you decide you're not going to use that hangar for any reason, you have to sell it and transfer that lease. We're still making money on the ground, or you have to take it out or give it to us.
Okay.
Really, that's how it works.
Okay.
So we do have control over the ground that's there. But they lease that ground from us. We make revenue off those hangars as well.
Great.
So,
anybody else have a question, comment? Any citizen question? All those in favor, so signify with your right hand. Thank you. I need a motion and a second to approve a bid from DC Taylor Company for replacement of the Sinveo building roof at 3010 North Industrial Road.
So moved.
Thank you. Thank you. Brad, please.
We have a need in the industrial building at 3010 for a new roof. As you know, Sinveo is the tenant there. They've recently signed a lease that they agreed as part of that lease agreement that they would help pay for approximately half of a new roof. We have put that roof out to bid to request companies on what they suggest is the best roof material and the best method for re-roofing that building. We got back 7 bids. One of the bids was for a coating, spray-on coating. We did not feel that was an effective way to re-coat. We didn't feel it had the long term, and the warranty did not go as long as what we were looking for. We ended up with 5 companies that bid the same material, and it's this material right here. It's a very tough, they call it thermal polyolefin. It's a tough reinforced fabric that's mechanically fastened, and the seams are heat welded together. They've also recommended this half inch cover board. What this does is once we get the existing roof off of there, there's an isocyanurate, it's about 1.25 inches of insulation. We have problems with that stuff. Some of that is wet because of the leaks that we've had. That has to be replaced. That insulation also compresses, and it causes the screws that mechanically fasten the roof, they tend to poke up. By the insulation of this, we think that gives you a nice smooth coating for the new plastic to lay down on top of, and it also spreads the load out so that you don't have the compression of that existing insulation, which will continue to some extent. And it's also another coat of insulation. So that's the material that we had from 5 different vendors. Lynn Collars and myself looked at all the quotes and the things that they recommended. We were also looking at replacing the coping cap for the perimeter of the roof. That was also removed at the last time the roof was replaced in 91 or 92, something like that. It's 45 years old in total, and it was replaced. Reinstalled at that time. It's not in very good shape, so this bid includes a replacement new material for that. We also plan to remove some of the equipment on the roof that's up there. We got some blowers and some buildings and some vents that are no longer required, and we plan to get that equipment off the roof to reduce the roof load, and it also lets you put the roof down so you don't have leaks in places that you have to flash around. The 5 vendors that used the roofing material, this TPO is probably the most popular roofing material for industrial buildings in the United States today. Of those 5 bids, DC Taylor was the lowest bid. That includes approximately 15,000 square feet of this wet insulation replacement. They had estimated around 10,000 square feet. We're estimating probably 15,000, but we will pay based on the square footage because it's a square footage price for that, not just a set amount. So if we actually only put in 10,000 square feet, that's a savings of $14,000. We won't have to pay if their number's right. We just want to make sure that we got enough money in there to cover this job. We are recommending DC Taylor. This is actually what they call a Carlisle 60 millimeter, again, TPO. The roof will have a 20-year labor and material warranty. And the total cost plus the roof installation and the cost of getting a crane to pull some of these bigger equipment off there looked to be $503,807. That includes the money for a crane. The project approved in our capital projects budget for $460,000. So some of these other projects will be reduced to make up that difference. And we spent a lot of time going over those bids, and we think we've got the best bid there is. Very experienced company. They are planning to start sometime around the end of February. If it's in 30-degree weather, 35 or above, they're going to be probably working.
Very succinct and thorough preparation.
Yeah, I mean, it's...
Presentation, I meant to say.
Yeah, there's a lot of work to do. I mean, there's a lot of roof to remove, and they'll be doing it sections at a time, but...
Any other council
questions?
Discussion?
Is there any salvage value for that equipment they're going to pull off the roof?
Yes, metal salvage. It'd go metal, because Simbeo has looked at it all. I've been there with the plant manager, and we thought they would use some of the motors, but they've taken another look, and they don't think they could use any of the motors and blowers. A lot of it's rusted, and some of it's really old, inefficient. Some great big 75-horse motors that we put them in 85 when I was out there, and they weren't efficient then. But nobody's going to want these motors. They're just going for a metal scrap.
Thank you.
Okay.
Questions from the citizens? All those in favor, so signify with your right hand.
Thank you.
I need a motion and a second to authorize the purchase of asphalt material from CB Asphalt Inc. for use on street and utility repair work.
So
thank you. Thank you. Alan, please.
Good evening again. These next items that I have are mainly housekeeping items for the just fall in line with council policies. So this one is for cold mix. This type of asphalt that we're asking for tonight is just a cold mix asphalt that we use all year round, mainly for pothole patching. The hot mix is a separate contract that we'll be coming back later with. Anyway, there's just two firms that have this. CB Asphalt is the closest, and since we drive, and the cheapest, but since we drive to pick it up, since we only order it in small lots, that makes it much more effective for us to purchase from CB Asphalt. So since they are the cheapest of the two local, we ask council's approval for this purchase.
Okay, any council discussion or citizen questions? All those in favor, so signify with your right hand. I can bring you like a bar stool from home so you can sit on. I see you're going to have five more presentations. I need a motion and a second to authorize the purchase of the asphalt. Let's see. Thank you. The purchase of concrete from Adair Concrete for street utility repair work and for facilities maintenance work.
Salute.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you.
Alan. Thank you. This one again. Adair Concrete being the only local supplier, and concrete is a unique product. Once you add water, you have a certain amount of time to put it on the ground. So we need to have somebody close, and since they're the only one in town, here we are. So we're asking for your approval. They are the ones that we have used for several years now. So
if you have any questions? Clarify quality, please. even though they're the only ones in town. They meet our
standards. Oh, yes, they meet the standards. That's correct. Yeah, it is a quality. We still get the quality product that we are asking for. Yeah, there's no question with that.
And since they are the only one in town, I have to think they're giving us a good price, since there's no other real bidders.
That I can't answer because they're the only bidder.
We need them to, and that's a, you know, I mean, that's a savings to us to be able to get the concrete.
Yes, well,
when we need it.
When we need it, yes.
Any other council discussion or citizen question? But all those in favor, see if I have the right hand, please.
Aye.
Any motion and a second to approve the bid from HC Waterworks Supply to supply fire hydrant extensions, valves, mount boxes, and cabinets.
So moved.
Thank you.
Aye.
Thank you.
Again, this is another housekeeping item. We purchase these on an annual basis for installation by our crews, and we also supply or sell them to the any developer who builds a tract here that uses them. That way we keep our standard, so we only have to have one set of repair kits and parts for all these types of fire hydrants instead of having half a dozen different types. But like I said, this is again housekeeping, just to get this supply back up for just these items that we use constantly.
Any discussion on those items? All those in favor, signify by the right hand, please.
Yeah.
I need a motion and a second to approve a bid from HC Waterworks Supply to supply pipe, valves, and fittings for water main construction and repair.
So moved.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you. Alan.
Again, this is the same type of a thing. We're getting all the rest of the parts that we use to install water services and water lines when we do our replacements all year long on this on the water system. So they were not, as you see, they were not the lowest bid, but the other bidder that was slightly under them had four different parts that were different than what we specified, and that they did not were parts that we don't like using because of the type of material it is. So we are asking that the council go with our choice for second bid in order to maintain the stock that we have and use parts that are compatible with the rest of our system. And it's still within the budget that council has approved for us for this year.
Thank you. Any discussion or citizens' questions? All those in favor, signify by the right hand. Thank you. I need a motion and a second to approve a bid from KV Motor Company for the purchase of two 2015 police vehicles, which will include the trade-in of two 2012 Dodge Chargers.
So moved.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you. Staff report, please.
And these are the two replacement police cars that the council authorized in the budget this year. We put it out to bid, and we had the two bidders, KV Motors and Love Green Ford. And KV Motors was the lowest bid on this for their Chevy Impalas versus the Ford Tauruses. And with the trade-in value that they gave us for the Dodge Chargers, they were well under our anticipated bid price, well within the budget the council had approved.
One thing I would like before you go, we do have the roof replacement at the Sendeo building that is over budget. But we're getting really good deals on the police cars. I know the council said you only wanted to replace two. We were planning to do three when we were talking to you originally. We reduced it down to two. I would like for you to allow us to revisit our budget, look at the revenues that we've received, and come back in March and see if we couldn't buy a third vehicle if we get the same kind of pricing. So basically getting a police car for $12,000. I mean, that's, we haven't seen that pricing before. So if there's no agreement, if you only want two cars, then I won't pursue it. But
you can find the money in the budget for three, $12,000 is cheap.
Yeah. What do the rest of you, Councilman, think? Three sounds good to me. We may not get this price again.
Well, yeah, I think that they're worth working with us on even a little bit more reduction, since we're going to go three over to two, if that's where we're going to go. I'd consider that thing.
Okay. All right, then, all we're asking for you to do is approve the bid tonight.
Okay.
But then, in the meeting in March, probably, if we can work it all out, we may come back with a third vehicle. Okay?
Okay. All those, if there's no other discussion, all those in favor of the presentation, say aye, right hand. Thank you. Good job, Alan. Did we, oh no, one more. Motion and second to approve a bid from Love Green Chrysler Center for the purchase of a 2015 van. Did I get a motion and second for that, please? Thank you. Alan.
Again, we had two bids, one from Love Green Chrysler and the other from Pogue Chrysler. And Love Green was the cheapest bid to supply us exactly what the police department requested in the way of a replacement van. And as noted here, there is no trade-in value on this one. Our goal will be to sell it outright because we can get a little bit more for it than a trade-in value.
All right. Any discussion or citizen questions? All those in favor, signify by your right hand, please. Thank you. Thank you, Alan. Good work. Any motion and second to approve a request for the use of city streets for the Kiwanis Easter Parade? Thank you.
A fairly straightforward request. I think this is the second year. I remember last year I threatened to sing a song when I was up here, so I remembered that. But this is reference the Kiwanis Easter Parade. It'll be Saturday, March 28th, late afternoon. Fairly straight shot as far as the parade route is concerned, just a few blocks from down Franklin Street from Missouri to Jefferson. I don't recall that we had any issues last year. We certainly are going to be talking, and I've directed staff to make sure that they've had contact or will have contact with the organizers. There is a little bit of concern with when the parade stops suddenly at a major intersection is what will happen with those people who were in the parade. It's not the only parade that does that, and so we'll just make sure we talk with them and provide them some guidance about how best to get their people back to the assembly area and how to avoid, you know, taking parade floats and people maybe on the back of parades and back of pickups into more normal traffic operations. So we will talk to them about that. But pretty straightforward and I think fairly consistent with last year.
Thank you, Chief. Any council discussion? Question? All those in favor, see if I have your right hand. Community service we provide. I need a motion and a second to approve the reappointment of Bob Giovannini and Philip Biston, and the appointment of Cole Woodcox to the Historic Preservation Commission for 3 terms there. Thank you.
Second.
Thank you.
Mayor and Council, we're asking you to reappoint Philip Biston and also...
He's the candidate.
Oh, I'm sorry, I thought there was a question there. Also, Bob Giovannini. Philip is completing his second 3-year term, and Bob was appointed to fill an unexpired term, so with this appointment, this will be his first full term. The other, Cole Woodcox, had served on this commission in the past. He's a valuable resource, has a lot of knowledge, and we'd really like the council to consider his appointment in place of Ken Shook, who does not wish to serve again.
Yeah, it sounds like all three men are good, knowledgeable men on their area of expertise. Any council discussion? Citizen question input? All those in favor, see if I have your right hand. I need a motion and a second to appoint Bob Concessions as ex officio members on the Lakes, Parks, and Recreation Commission. Thank you. Gents?
Mayor and Council, this is a little different because it's not a person, it's an entity. Cobb Concessions really is the Cobb family. Steve Cobb had been an ex officio member to the Lakes Parks and Recreation Commission for many years. Basically, he would show up when he saw something on the agenda that was pertinent to Forest Lake. The concessionaire, Cobb Concessions, runs the boathouse, the restaurant, the fishing, the swim beach, the boat rentals. They operate that those concessions and have a contractual agreement with the Department of Natural Resources. We'd like to encourage someone from their operation to attend those meetings, and to do that, instead of just appointing one, we're asking that if one of them can attend, then you know, that's why we're putting it down as the business, not an individual.
So I'm hearing you to say that we would be asking one of the family members to come at a time?
We invite them to attend, but by making, instead of saying that it's going to be Jeremy, we're asking that it just be the business and a representative. So it could be Jeremy or his wife, Robin, or Steve's wife, Glenda.
Okay.
Just makes it a little more flexible, and maybe we'll encourage them to be there.
Any other council discussion? Susan, question input? All those in favor, signify with your right hand. Okay. Any motion and a second to reappoint Mary Maycomer, Lacey King, and Ashley Young to 3-year terms on the South 63 Corridor Community Improvement District Board?
So moved.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you. Sir?
Mayor and Council, the Community Improvement District was established in 2010. Since its inception, we've had 3 city representatives, and then the developer has had 2 representatives. We are asking the council to reappoint myself, Lacey King, and then Assistant City Manager Ashley Young to serve for 3 more years on that board.
Thank you. Any council discussion? Citizens' questions? All those in favor, signify with your right hand. Any motion and a second to approve to appoint Annette Sweet to serve on the K-Ready Board as a representative of the City of Kirksville?
So moved.
Thank you. Any second?
Sure.
Thank you, Richard.
Mayor and Council, Ms. Sweet currently serves as your representative to the K-Ready Board. With your new structure, the feedback that I got from Council is that you wish to have her continue to serve. She is currently the secretary to the K-Ready Board and is willing to continue to serve in that capacity if the Council wishes to reappoint her.
Thank you, Mary. Any Council discussion for Ms. Sweet? Citizens' questions? All those in favor of this appointment, signify with your right hand.
Okay.
All those opposed?
Substain.
And substain. Abstain, okay. All right. We need a reading of bills that were adopted on the first reading.
An ordinance determining capture of economic activity taxes of Melody School of Dance and Tumbling of Kirksville that relocated to the downtown tax increment financing redevelopment area after December 27, 1999. An ordinance determining capture of economic activity taxes of Security Finance of Missouri LLC of Kirksville that relocated to the South 63 Corridor tax increment financing redevelopment area after July 20th, 2009. An ordinance of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, authorizing the execution of a contract between the City of Kirksville and the Missouri Highways and Transportation Commission for Transportation Alternatives Program funds, and establishing the mayor and city manager as authorized representatives for the City of Kirksville, and an ordinance of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, granting a special use permit for construction of a radio tower antenna on Kirksville R3 property at 1901 East Hamilton Street.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I need a motion and a second to approve bills on second reading.
So moved.
And any council further discussion or citizens' questions? All those in favor, signify with your right hand. This is the time for any council comments. Well, I just want to say briefly that I really swelled with pride as we sat through the previous State of the City address by the city manager, assistant city manager, and all the department heads, of whom I just have the highest confidence in and enjoy a great working relationship with all those people. And again, I'm just proud of all the accomplishments we were able to undertake in 2014 and look forward to a really even better 2015. Thank you. So I need a motion and a second to adjourn.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Appreciate everybody coming tonight on this snowy night. The meeting is now adjourned.